reaches enormous proportions in the mining industry, and it is used extensively in factories, for large construction projects, and by corporations worldwide. Alfred Nobel becomes a very wealthy man. Alfred Nobel dies in 1896, but shortly before this, he decides what he is going to do with his wealth. One can argue, perhaps his best idea yet. He has many relatives, but no direct family, no wife, and no children. Therefore, he decides to establish a prize to award those who are conferred to have contributed for the greatest benefit to humankind. It is to be called the Nobel Prize. This award will be divided into different categories. Physics, chemistry, and medicine are obvious choices due to their significance in his own research. But Alfred Nobel also has a passion for poetry, something he himself wrote in his youth. So literature is chosen as another prize category. Being a cosmopolitan man with a commitment to the growing peace movement, he chooses to dedicate the last category to peace. In 1968, a sixth prize was added, Sveriges Riksbank Prize in Economic Sciences, in memory of Alfred Nobel. For over 100 years, the Nobel Foundation has managed the assets made available through the will of Alfred Nobel to nominate and reward, to review and announce, and of course, to orchestrate the grand ceremony awarding those who live and serve in accordance with his ideal. Over the years, the number of Nobel laureates has multiplied, including men and women all over the globe, both famous and lesser known. The courage, creativity, and curiosity of these laureates inspire us and give us hope for the future of humankind. And here, at the Nobel Museum in Stockholm, we have gathered the gems and treasures worthy of the awards. The stories, the objects, and the publications tell us tales about some of the greatest ideas in the world. Follow Marie Curie and her research in radioactivity. Look over the letters written by Albert Einstein, the physicist whose theories changed our perception of the world. Hear the story of Alexander Fleming and the mold that saved millions of lives. Look at Barbara McClintock's corn cobs that led her to the discovery of changing chromosomes. Listen to Martin Luther King's unforgettable speech for human rights. And see the Shah Malala Yousafzai war while addressing the UN regarding children's right to education.
The thorn, there's a bullet, silence.
The Nobel Prize shows that ideas can change the world. So come on in. Explore. Discover and be inspired. This treasure is all yours. Imagine yourself in a chamber of treasures. Here lie some of the world's most innovative ideas. Tidings that changed the world. Thoughts that changed people. Discoveries that changed science. Action that saved lives. This is a treasure trove of the greatest. greatest steps of progress for humankind. And it all started with one idea. One man, and his name was Alfred Nobel. Continues his work by adding diatomite, a soft powder made from fossil remains, to the nitroglycerin. He develops a safer material that's easier to work with. Nobel calls his creation dynamite. The demand for this invention reaches enormous proportions in the mining industry, and it is used extensively in factories, for large construction projects, and by corporations worldwide. Alfred Nobel becomes a very wealthy man.